So, hello friends. It's my pleasure to be with you another time. So, let's have a talk about this running course. So, I'm cordially welcoming you, all of you. It's our online repertory training course 2020. And this is the video I wish to prepare for conclusion. We are at the end of the course, so I want to say something. We want to repeat something and let's make a conclusion. I hope you like the course, you enjoy, we all enjoy. When I also enjoy a lot, our mentors, our teachers, everybody like the course so much. So it's kind of a happy journey, right? So we enjoy a lot together. For conclusion, we first of all we try to make a revision what we had learned till now. So first I wish to talk about case exercises. It's immensely helpful and it's a wonderful thing, right? So during case exercises we learn several things, so we'll repeat them. Like we first of all in first case, we especially in first case and other cases also, we try to understand that how to classify symptoms. So our entire course is basically focused on the symptom centric case analysis, right? And in symptom centric case analysis we try to understand the common symptoms, what is the common symptoms, what are the uncommon symptoms, what are the peculiar symptoms, generals, causation, modality, concomitant. We try to classify them. So this is the, you can say, the perfect way to make your analysis more analytical, more systematic. Generally in our analysis what we do, just take the case, collect the symptoms, put them in repertory, and whatever medicine or we refer in materia medica or that way. But our work is not so precise, it's not so complete, it's not so systematic, and that is needed in our practice. Without that systematic analysis we get failed. That I observe in my cases. So once I observe my failure cases, once I read out my failure cases, then I find out a point, like whenever I get failed, the reason behind my failure is I had not worked enough in my case. So this is first important thing. If you work enough in your case, then you overcome over your failures. So if you want to reduce your failures, you have to put more effort in case analysis. Generally we try to focus on case taking, but we do not make a more effort in case analysis. But it is very very important to have a confidence over your prescription, to come on the correct medicine. And we learn a lot of methods and you can say techniques and arts in this series of 1 month, right? Then after we try to understand the four-dimensional analysis for acute cases. Especially in acute cases, you have to look for four things. It's not necessary in each and every case you have these four, all the points should be clear. If your case has that all four points should be clear, then it would be an ideal case, right? But it is not necessary to have all the points. But it is necessary to at least you have a 2-3 points, a 2-3 dimension of your analysis in acute cases. These analyses are common symptoms, uncommon symptoms, peculiar symptoms, causation, modality and concomitant. These four points. So, let's generally even in course, during course, many students has make query also like cough, night aggravation, lying down aggravation mentioned by Kent, like this is commonly there in almost all cough cases, and it is true also. Same way, fever, when you have a fever, you have a thirst, your body need more water to reduce the fever, right? So this way, a thirst during a fever is common symptom. So you have to avoid these symptoms. This is suggestion from many of the students, and I agree also with them. But my question is, suppose these are a common symptom and it has no use in homeopathy, then why these symptoms are presented in repertory and materia medica? If they are there in materia medica, then there might be some use of them in homeopathy. Because in homeopathy, I believe there is nothing useless. Everything should have their perfect and sensible place. So, this is the reason. And I find out in my practice, like, this is the way we can use common symptoms. So, common symptoms become important when they are very, very prominent. If your case has a fever, a normal fever, like 99 degrees Fahrenheit or 100, and it comes and goes automatically, it has no need of a special care, then we have to take this rubric or this symptom in a case or not during analysis. No, because it's a very, very common. But if your fever stay longer time, it produces very prominent effect on the person, then you must have to select it. This is the way. If the prominent, any common symptom, it becomes very, very prominent in the case, then you have to take it. And that's why, and only in acute cases you have to take a common symptom. And in pathological cases also, you have to take common symptom. Like your case has a prostate enlargement, then every prostate issue or case has prostate enlargement, right? So it becomes common to all prostate disease related all cases, but you have to take it. So this way, in acute and in pathological cases, common symptoms have a special value. So this is the way. This is the way it produces a four-dimensional analysis method in acute cases. Common symptom, uncommon, common symptom associated with special features. This is we call uncommon. I call it specially, I don't know. But I call them uncommon because a common symptom associated with another, like fever. Fever is associated with flu, then you become uncommon, and we call them catarrhal fever, right? So same way, malaria, constant fever, typhoid, that way it become uncommon. If common symptom is associated with modality, then also it become uncommon. But all uncommon symptoms are not always peculiar. You have to select a one or two, or if possible, a very, very rare kind of symptom in your case. This is we call, I call especially a peculiar symptom. So this peculiar symptom also you have to consider, and you have to place this peculiar or general symptoms or something causative factor or something very, very you can say the wish has a very big value in the case to confirm the medicine. The repertorization might have come with many medicine, but you have to look for those symptoms which cover the maximum symptoms covered by one medicine. So this is the way you confirming that, and that we learn in case one, right? Another thing, generally once we take a case and analyze, then straight away we try to look for the medicine. But it is not also, you can say, the good habit. You have to look the case from all the angles. You have to look from case from the, even starting from the case taking, you have to look for the common symptoms, uncommon symptoms, periphery, associated complaints, chief complaints, some peculiars might be there, general symptoms might be there. But the information should be spontaneous. It has some, you can trust them, that must the value, evaluated information must be there. So this is the way you have to check the case from all the angles, that we learn in case exercises, right? Another thing you can observe, like in all four cases, I have selected a same chief complaint, similar, very respiratory complaints, right? All are looking like a acute or semi-acute cases. But in all cases you can see the case taking technique is little different. And first case, suppose a person has chief complaint all, and then smoke aggravation and all, and person start try to talk about the personality, I do not give importance. But in second case, the child is very talkative, very cherish, very attractive, I consider them. So this is, you can say, the case taking skill is also needed. Like this much I need in this case. You have to make a border. This much the information I want. The change during the acute is very important. So you have to look only for the change. And if the case has that exacerbation of the chronic hidden disease, then you have to consider the personality and chronic symptoms also. But it is not necessary in each and every case that it should be there. Sometimes it not be there. Then also, you can go. So this way, it requires a lot of different patterns, different techniques in case taking. Same way, you require many different skills in case analysis also. And you see, in all cases look very similar, but each case require a different skill, right? So this is the reason we call a repertory an art. Our repertorization is artful process. This is the reason. So same way, after the repertorization, you have to confirm the medicine by different ways. Either using of the peculiars, after eliminating factors, many eliminating factors, referring materia medica, using different repertory. So same way, you have to confirm that. Why you have to do this process, confirmation? This is the way you gain the confidence over your prescription. This is the process gives you confidence on your selection of medicine. So it's very necessary. Generally, during the prescription of, you can say, the medicine, you do not have confidence like this medicine is going to work or not. But if your analysis and your working process, everything is a skillful, a little technical, then you gain the confidence. So this is the we learn in case exercises. In case 3, we generally know, and This is we try to learn even. Like patient's language, you have to convert in repertorial language and your duty over. But in case 3 is kind of a very showing us mirror, like where we are making mistake, right? So, conversion of patient language into repertorial language is not enough. It is just a first step. But then after something is also there. And that after step is to confirm the medicine. So just selection of rubric is not enough. You need more skill, you need more techniques. Another thing we learn is case analysis in pure acute case is different than semi-acute cases. That also you see. In pure acutes, you do not need to apply lot of skill and techniques. Just select whatever there in case, put them in repertory. Come whatever medicine coming up, select one and give them. So in acute, you do not need to be so much focused, because in acute your similar medicine also work, because your vital force is enoughly disturbed by itself because of infection or whatever the cause, because of the acute condition of your health. And that's why a similar medicine, a similar you can say the stimulus also make a vital force to remove the disease. But in semi-acute, it is not true. And that's why you need to find a something exact match kind of a medicine. So this is, we learn also, like in pure acute, the case analysis is little different than semi-acute and acute exacerbation of the chronic disease, right? One more thing we learn, in each and every acute case, you need to check acute totality and constitutional totality both. This is also very important. Many times we are going to mistake. Whatever symptom we are going to select and medicine coming up. But actually, some cases you have to focus only on acute. Some cases you have to confirm both the things. And especially in semi-acute cases, this both the totality must be covered by your medicine, generally. If not covered by your medicine, a constitutional thing is not covered by your medicine, then you have to treat the acute first and then go for the chronic. Retake the case, find out the other symptoms and find out the constitutional medicine. Another point we learn is you need to be more focused rather to just learn how to convert patient's language into repertorial language. If you are a beginner, you know much about the repertory, then how to convert patient's language into repertorial language is enough for you. So you have to first focus on them, then after you need to be more skillful. So there are many techniques, many skills are there. It's not just these are the just 3-4 techniques are there and you can deal with your cases enoughly. There are many things are there, clinical things, which is, these are the things that you can apply readily in your practice within a, just you learn and second day you can apply in your practice. So these kind of things, very practical kind of things. Another thing we learn in our fourth case, like suppose you fail with one tool, Then what to do? You have to go for another technique, another repertory, another methodology. And this is the reason you have to learn multiple technique, multiple skill, multiple approaches, multiple methodologies. It's not enough to just be familiar with one repertory or one materia medica and you get become a successful. But from beginning, if you focus on all and everywhere, then also you get fail. So this, you have to focus on other things once you master the one thing. So first your focus should be the master of one thing which is easy, which is simple, and which is you feel like I can manage this thing. Do not follow the crowd. Like all body goes with Sankaran, all bodies goes with Vitulkas, so go with Vitulkas or Vijaykar or whatever, mind method or whatever. And just go with them because your classmates and colleagues and students and or might be one teacher had given a very beautiful seminar in your town and you become like a devotee to that person. It's not true. You have to find out which is best for me and then follow that. Because in homeopathy, everything has their place and every method, every technology, every approach has their, you can say, the place. They have also success. Everything is very good. But everything is not for me that you have to learn. And one more thing. Whatever process or approach is going on and you jump and go there, it's also not good. You have to select one. If you have to master, if you have to be focused. One day you go in Sankaran, another day you go with Vitulkas, and another day you go with Praful Vijaykar simultaneously, then it is not good. Whatever method, even Kent, Boger, Bonninghausen, whatever methodologies are there. Calcutta method is also there. Keynote methods are also there. So, whatever method is there, but you have to go in that method at the depth of that method. Learn by heart and then only you can master it. Then after the field is open, you can go with anything. So this way you become a master of multiple things. Another thing we learn, like each repertory has their own place in homeopathy. So initially I said you, like you do not have to focus on many repertories. But each repertory has their value. Now what to do? We have to focus in multiple repertories, but not from very first day, step by step. Once you master one thing, then go for another and learn how to use them in practice. So these are the points we learn in case exercises and it's worthy to apply them in practice. And I am sure you started to apply them in your practice also. Because it's immensely important things, immensely practical kind of thing that you can apply directly in your practice within a day. And it gives you confidence, like these approaches, these skills, techniques going to help you in your practice for sure. Now, our exciting things. The everybody love it. It is a rubric exercises. Oh, it gives you a kind of, you can say you become a fan of the repertory because of this. There are many reasons, but main reason is kind of the exercises are kind of a game for us because it's excite us. We get in touch with the repertory in daily base. In case exercise, we have to wait to have an answer for 1 week. Because as a mentor, as a teacher, we have to wait for answer of the all participants. And that's why we have given a more time. But in rubric exercises, you are in touch with the repertory every day. So it's more adorable in compared to case exercises. But I see you friends, rubric exercises are just for a game. Because it's not making a big difference in our practice. If you want to have a big difference in your practice, then case exercises are must be there in your practice. Because in your own case, if you make a lot of mistakes as you do in these all case exercises, I know whatever the mistakes you had done all, right? There are many mistakes. So suppose same mistakes you do in your practice, then surely you have a lot of failures. And after many failures, you come on the right way of selection of medicine, right? But I say, these case exercises give you opportunity to make a fault, make a mistake. That's why case exercises are heart of, you can say, the core of the course. Though it is not so, you can say, the glamorous as like rubric exercises. But rubric exercises also hold you, to bond up you with the repertory. It's breaking our barrier to think. You have a limitation to think. If you have to widen your thought process, then you need these exercises. This way our thoughts become wide. Like person gives you this kind of expression, you can think in this direction. Another thing, every time our mentor says, work more, you are wrong, work more, they give us hints, right? So, why they are doing this? Because they are trying to make us a more precise. You need to be exact. Repertory is kind of mathematics. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2 and it should be always 2. Right? In repertory also, you need to find the exact rubric. Whatever your patient says, you need that. The words are not important. Like, give you example, somebody had written a lot of answers, like day blindness rubric. Person says, I am not able to see during the daytime. And many body taken a lot of rubrics, like a dim vision during daytime. But actually it is a dim vision? No, it is a blindness. So that exactness, dim vision and blindness, two things is there. But you have to pick one thing. Exact, that precision is you have by these exercises. And it's necessary. It's not a within a one night or within a 1 month, you become a master in selecting a, pick out an exact rubric all the time. Even after many years experience, we are also making lot of mistakes. So, there is a place to make a mistake. But as much you can. So this way, it makes you more precise. Precision is coming in us. Another main motto to have a rubric exercise is to make you familiar with the repertory. What are the chapters? What are the rubrics? What are the sub-rubrics? Where they are? You are searching. You are just going through the all repertory chapters and everything. Then you become familiar. Right. This is here. This is here. And it's really going to help you when you have a real case. So, this is the way it It's kind of, I funnily say, it's kind of a friendship process. Rubric exercises are friendship process. It's just making you a friendship bell. Rubric exercise is kind of friendship bell. You become a friend of the repertory, day by day. Otherwise, we avoid them or we get scared. Repertory is not for me. It's not good. Or sometimes, some good days, you try out. Just we can add the repertory rubrics in computer. And you have one or two or three failures and you put them in dustbin. This is many homeopaths had this experience, right? But I'm sure after this much of the effort, you become a fan of the repertory. Now I have 100% confidence. You do not lack the repertory in your entire life. Though you might have failures, but you do not lack them. You try to improvise yourself. And this is our main motto. Within a 1 month, nobody is going to make you master of repertory in entire world. Even 1 year is not enough. So, our main motto is to make you that friendship with the repertory. And I am sure you become a friend of with the repertory after this much of exercises. Our teachers, mentors, kept a lot of effort behind it. It's not easy to answer everybody, to make them clear if they have a doubt, to encourage them, to give them hint. You need to be active. And it was you can say, the precious time they have spent behind you. So, because all mentors, all teachers are not sitting free in their life. They have their very, very busy practice. I say you this, all mentors, they have a very busy practice. They are seeing at least 30-40 patients per day. They are very, very successful homeopath. Though they love the repertory, and because of that attachment, so much attachment with the repertory, they are ready to convey that enthusiasm, that spirit to the all world, all of you, right? So, I'm sure with this course, I'm 100% sure, because this is not my first course on repertory. So, I have made many experimentation with my students, with my courses. So, I know, after this course, you become so spirited. You are ready to do anything. You are ready to fight any kind of battle in your homeopathic practice. So, this way you become very positive, very confident. You become passionate behind the repertory course. And I am sure some of you also started to have a practice on your own to find the different cases and work on them. And either if you are you have a leader kind of quality, then you started to give even rubric exercises to your juniors also. Right? So, you are so enthusiastic, so eager, so spirited, active, passionate, right? Positive. So, after this repertory course, you have this much all qualities. Your student within you become awakened. It was in deep freeze. Now it become active. So, my question to all of you is, what is next? What's next? You have all spirit, all enthusiasm, all techniques. You can say you become now passionate behind the repertory. But what now onward, what we have to do? So our first motto of this course is to ignite this energy, this enthusiasm in all of you. And for that I had, by hook or crook, I had made lot of dramas and all kind of messages sending you course is going to stop or you are out of the course, it's not real. If you feel bad, then I am very sorry, but it's our intention is to make you active. And finally, I am very, very satisfied from your answers, your participation. So now what is next? It's possible to, because I am not able to reach to the every corner of the world, but you can, because I am a one and you are 766. So it's possible to reach to the world. And this is our motto. Energy is transformed from our teachers, mentors to the students. But our next step is to pass on this energy, the enthusiasm, this spirit to the others. If you are able to ignite this same spirit, whatever or whatever experience you had in this 1 month, to others, multiple ways are there. But if you are able to pass on this energy to others, we are so happy and our motto fulfilled. This is kind of, we have to take a kind of a mission. It's a movement kind of thing. It's to all whatever possible homeopath get together and learn together and ignite that spirit in us. This is our main motto. Now you might have a question like, how we will do this? Because we are not teacher, we have not contacts, or many questions are there. But there are multiple ways. We can make a good review on social media, wherever the groups we have. So if we give a good reviews, then other people get attracted towards the course, towards this activity. And they feel something good is going to happen. Because it's not a simple number. 766 students get benefited. Even personal one-to-one level learning is there. Then it should be something huge. It should be something big. And they get attracted, they come in touch with you and you can make them understand. Or either you go in the seminars or any gatherings or any meetings, at that time you convey like this kind of activity is going on and you have to take part. You have to take benefits rather than part, take benefits. So you have also good practice in your life, you get benefited. So this way, in WhatsApp, in Facebook or Instagram or wherever you are in touch with other homeopaths, a qualitative homeopath, then pass on this energy to them. Another way you can do is produce a small group, whoever you are known, and try to learn together. Meet together. If you, in your city, you are a 5 homeopaths, get together. Learn every Sunday, Tuesday, Wednesday, whatever one day fix in the week. Get together. Try to learn. Try to read repertory rubrics. Try to find out their meanings in dictionary. At least, read out all sub rubrics. Try to work on cases. And carry on this energy, because if 1 month we try our best to ignite the highest energy in you, highest that positive energy in you, but now you have to use that energy in constructive way. So you build a good practice in your life, and finally we are able to help a sick mankind. This is our prime motto, right? Another thing, if you pass on this message to others, is not end. The journey should be continued. So this kind of learning process should be going on for you, for me, for teachers, for mentors, everybody. How, I don't know, but you have to continue your journey. You have to use, you know, you have that spirit, that passion within you, because we show you mirror. You are able to with lot of difficulties. Many people are sick in your family, many student has that, many problems, marriages are there, exams are there in many students, though they become active and try to learn. So it's a big thing. I really appreciate that. But that energy should be going on. The learning should be always there. So we make you aware, like you are also a student. Otherwise, you become a practitioner, right? So that was our main motto, to make, create awareness in you, like you are also a student. Now you believe you are also a student. So you do not have to die that student within you. If you make them okay, you become inactive, then student automatically die within you. So this is first thing. How would we can carry on journey? I have stressed out few points, like you can learn self-learning. How would I make you understand? In when I observe in rubric exercises, especially, you are not able to find the rubric. There are 2-3 reasons, like you are not aware of the repertory, you are not able to convert that patient language into repertory, and third important thing, the mostly I see in abroad students, especially Romanian students, because they are not aware of a good English, and this is also there in my, especially my state, Gujarat students, because our first language is not English. Our English is our second language. We are not using English language in our day-to-day life, and that's why we are not aware of many words. And the game is mainly on words, right? I have selected that way. So words are very, very important in repertory, and you have to learn them. So what you have to do? Open repertory, starting from first point, chapter wise, but especially in mind, go through all words in dictionary. Select one word, like absent-minded, from A, absent-minded, look in the dictionary, what the exact meaning of absent-minded. Then another. So, it called a terminology. So, you need to make a full note, ABCD wise, all notes of all terminology. Starting from A to Z, and in different repertories. Select one or two first, because it's not possible to master all repertory all together. Step by step you can. So select first repertory, especially can't or complete or fatter, and go with that terminology. Explore that terminology step by step, one after one. Even a simple word, the leg has that inner part, a soul has that inner part. We don't know it's a hollow, because it's not touching the ground, so it's kind of a hollow, it's kind of empty part, right? But we don't know. So you have to look that whole of word in repertory, in dictionary. Same way, many words are there. So this way you become enriched in terminology. Another way you can learn the repertory is find out the cross references. If you have a software, then use it and look for the cross references. Suppose your patient is jealous, then look also for envy. Like, what does the meaning of envy? in which condition or what kind of situation or what quality person has, so I can use this envy. So cross references, cross rubrics, similar looking rubrics. Suppose you have a rubric exercises for day blindness, then look, there might be a night blindness, right? So opposite also. So this way you become familiar and you learn the repertory. So this way self-learning is there. Another way you can learn yourself is case exercises. Do not left any single case to work on repertory. I see. Wherever you find, in the books, in the software, in the you can say the website, anywhere you find the case, do not look in the analysis. Make your own analysis and then check. Because this gives you confidence, like this person has selected a pulsatilla and my way also coming up pulsatilla. It gives you a lot of confidence. Here, I want to remind you, or you can say that I appreciate one of our mentors, Dr. Ganeshwara Rao. Before few days, he had a seminar in his town, nearby town, with a sensation method practitioner, Dr. Mahesh Gandhi. His way of stylist evolution method, right? A little different than sensation, but it's very kind of sensation method. Now you know, in sensation method, they do not use rubrics in each and every case. But in live seminar, Ganeshwara Rao, what he had done, he go with the computer and along with his daughter. Daughter is also homeopath, Priyanka. Both are sitting together and try to look in computer all the rubrics, whatever Mahesh Gandhi or doctor has explained the case. He work according to his way, and his surprise, nearly 80 to 90% cases he come on the medicine. So this is the way he get confidence, like the my work on repertory. If I am not good with this evolution method or sensation method, then only I come on the medicine with another way. And it gives you immensely pleasure, like it has no words. I can say it has no words to explain, like how much you are happy when you come on the medicine, right medicine, in another person's case. It gives you so much satisfaction, like I had done something good. And it gives you confidence in your learning, like I'm on right track. And this is very, very important, because nobody is going to see you are doing right. So this is very important. And I really appreciate this enthusiasm, this spirit. This spirit must be there in you. So from as we have completing the course, you go with course exercises, case exercises, do lot of cases, whatever you can find, and this is the way you gain the confidence on your repertory skill. Another thing is you have to read. As our teacher Dr. Yamini has explain, like you have to read every day 10 rubrics. It's true. If you have to learn the repertory, you have to go through rubrics. You need to be familiar. So reading is also very, very important. Another thing is seminars. Seminars, you can learn several things, several techniques, but it has not made so big impact on your life, but it ignite a spirit. For a moment, you become a student. So it's very, very important in practical life. Another issues, another way you can learn is in generals. Seminar workshops are similar, right? So in journals, you have many cases, many things, and you can learn a lot from them. You can select case and work on them on your own. Extract the important points as I do in my case exercises. Then make a portrait and then repertory, everything. So I had show you a path. Like this way you have to do. Now up to you. You have to be student or you become a dying. Your student within you, you have to make them suicide. That you have to decide, right? Now, this is the conclusion. But there are several general questions or queries coming up in this course. And it's going to include an entire our group and all the people. So, I selected few questions to discuss here. Many students ask, like, I want to become a part of, I want to make you a teacher, I want to make you a mentor, I want to become a part of this journey for ever and ever. So this is first question. Is other courses with you? Because this is 1 month short course. So is there a long term courses or other courses are there? This question is there. So the if you have a misunderstanding here, you might have, like, this course is just to make a marketing of what I am doing in my practice. So it's not true. Actually, the course has their own place, and by heart we have put our, honestly, we have put our all possible energy in this course. So it's not just for marketing. And even I say you, it's not necessary to be with us all the time. Even after the course, if you forget all of our teachers, all 8 teachers and mentors and me, then we do not have any disappointment. But don't forget repertory. Don't forget a student within you. This is our main request to you. Otherwise, it's not kind of that thing, like we want to include with us and join you all in this kind of paid courses. So that's why we have made this free course. It's not that our intention. Our intention is to ignite a student within you. You become student and start to learn yourself or join somewhere where there is a learning process going on. Sit with a very good homeopath in your city. There are many good homeopaths are there, and they are kind also to make you aware about homeopathic all possible practical things, right? So little bit I will talk about my courses. There are 2 courses I decide to have from this year onward, a clinical course and conceptual course. The 2 different things, basic course and advanced course. In basic course or clinical course, we are going to learn about case taking, case analysis, repertory and acutes. Because acutes are very important. If you have to boost up your practice within a short time, you want to have a good results or you want to have a good number of patients, then you have to focus on acutes. Generally, all homeopaths, maximum homeopaths, are scared from the acutes. They are not able to handle the acutes, or either they are so busy with some pathological cases and all, so they forget or they sidetrack them. But I observe one thing, whoever very successful homeopath, they have a mastery over acutes. So acute is very important in our practice. If you have to boost up your practice or you have to learn lot of things, then you have to focus on acute. And especially for students and beginners, I want to say, you must have to focus on acutes, because you have to gain confidence of your patients. And if you are dealing a chronic case, then how long time you have to wait to have a confidence on homeopathy on you? Imagine, even a skin problem take few months, then after person see the results and then they have a confidence over you, over the homeopathy. But imagine in state of that pathological case or skin case or migraine case or whatever, gynec case, psychiatric case, suppose you are treating a fever case, and how many days the person gain confidence over you? Within 2-3 days, because within 2-3 days you show them results, you show the efficacy of homeopathy. Yes, homeopathy is work. So it is a best chance to show your patient the results. If you want to show that efficacy, then you have to choose the acute cases. So acute cases are very, very important in our practice. And this is the reason this year we decide to focus all learning on the base of acute. You can learn case taking, you can learn case analysis, you can learn repertory, but cases are only acute. That methodology you can use in general practice also. It's not only about acute, but focus is on acute cases. So multiple case taking skills, multiple case analysis skill, multiple repertory, what you have to do, confirmation and all whatever we see in this course, it's an extended form of this course, a clinical courses. Only thing is it has not rubric exercises, because rubric exercises we kept only for this course. Another course is conceptual course. I am by heart, I am a sensation method practitioner. So I am also attached with sensation method, and that's why we decide to have advanced courses rather than basic course. It's something advanced, right? So we have a course on different kingdoms. Animal kingdom, plant kingdom, mineral kingdom, no soul, sarcode, imponderabilia. In animal kingdom, we have two more courses are there, mammals and birds. So this way, we have conceptual courses. Clinical course generally will launch in February. And this conceptual course, we try to launch them in June, July, maybe. So this is the way we have courses. But you have freedom. It's to go with and learn with anybody. If you like our way of methodology, our teaching style or concepts, or if you benefited, like you feel like this is the way you are going to benefit, then stay with us. Otherwise you have freedom to go anywhere. But don't lack the learning. Go anywhere. All teachers are very good. Everybody is teaching you at least. So, nothing is useless. I am not saying like I am the only person or my team is only thing or way of courses are only thing you can learn in entire world. You have freedom. Go anywhere. No problem. Now, this funny question are there from many homepage. And I even also feel like the course gets finished. This is the idea I have in mind. Like just few days before we started and just finished. Though we enjoy a lot and we learn a lot of things. But shall we continue this process for longer time? But I have one question. me and entire team, my all teachers and mentors, we have very busy practice. So it's not possible to spend lot of time behind this process. And we have to run our practice, right? So we have to focus on our thesis also. Because lot of way we are compromising our busy practice. We have to wake up at night. I am at 1 a.m. today. I am talking. This is 1 a.m. Right? I am compromising my sleep right now. And talking with you in this video. So, this way, it's not possible to spend lot of time. So, it's not possible to continue this process for longer time. But, as you ask this question to many times, many students ask, this is not question from one student. I have this query from lot of students, you can say. Then after we decide to and we promise, because I discuss with my team, and then we decide every year we are going to give you this kind of stimulation every year. This is our promise. So after a year in 2021, for sure we get together again, and this is I am going to announce Repertory online Repertory training course 2021. So get ready to have thrill again after 1 year. And for this period, you make ready other homepage to get benefit. Whoever in your contact, either talk to them personally, you can send message, or wherever you meet them in seminar or other courses, or wherever you meet them, just try to explain like this is a very good place where you can learn. And this togetherness is very important. We are all together. So, if you have, or even me or other homeopaths have any problem in their life, especially homeopathic life, then they do not feel like I am alone. Because it's a strength of 700, 800 students. So, you do not get frustrated like you have. Suppose mainly problem we have in failures. And it make you frustrated. So, suppose you try 1 case, 2 case, 3 case, 5 case, 7 case. Few cases you have a result and few cases you don't have results. This make it immensely frustrating. But if you are together, suppose your case is for failure, but when you see the successful case of other homeopath, again that homeopathic animal within us get awakened. A child within us awakened. So, it's necessary. That togetherness is necessary. And this is the way we get together. And our motto is to include more friends, more students. This time we are 700. Next time I believe if you make an effort, because I am not able to reach to the everyone, right? So if you make an effort, then next time we'll be double up, at least 1,000. And we'll enjoy a lot. We get together. It's kind of a game for us, right? We learn together, enjoy together, have fun, everything, right? But final my message to you. Always be student. Not allow a student within you to die. Always be a student. This is our main a motto, inspirational force. Many times even my colleagues and everybody ask me, like where from you get this much of energy to share this all the thing to this much amount of crowd of people. But the inspiration behind this all process is to, I want to make all the people to awaken their student within them. This is my spirit. This is my energy. It gives me that inspiration. So this is my main motto. Finally, I want to say a lot of thank you to many all of you. So if you are not there in the course, then we are not there. So thank you so much. Even during the course, I need to be very strict, hard to many of them. Even I write them some difficult words also. So forgive us. Even after the course, if you forget us, then we don't mind. Because our motto is to awaken a student within you, and we have made our duty. So it's kind of a duty for us. So it's a success of all of us. I'm also thankful to teachers, especially Dr. Bhavesh Yamini. They give their valuable time and they provide us videos, so you enjoy their videos. And mentors, all my team, like Dr. Ganeshwara Rao, Sonu Mahatra, because of ill health in his family, he is not able to join the course, but he is ready to serve. So I'm also thankful to him. Dr. Geeta, Gayatri, even I say you become a fan of your mentors also, because they are also very kind hearted, very good persons. Why? Because I selected them because of their good virtues, not because of they are a good homeopath, right? So by heart they are also very good persons. And next time we are going to, when we have a new fresh course in 2021, at that time also we try to have the same mentors with you, so you also have you can remember your back memories, because these are very good memories with us, your memories with us, and you have also good memories from teachers and mentors, right? So these memories always stay with us. It's kind of a big thing. It's not a small thing. A repertory course, free repertory course, was a big thing. As per my experience or my memory, there is no course in the entire world till now where this much of the big crowd get together and learn together. I don't know. If it might be out of my knowledge, but as per I know, it's the first time in world. So it's a big thing, right? It's a proud moment for us to have that, you can say, the course together. It's a proud moment for us, because it's kind of a record for us to have this big crowd work together, get together and stay tuned with each other every day. It's a big thing. One to one level we have a togetherness. It's not either. There are many places where they have a webinars and videos on YouTube, but they are not have a personal touch as we have in this course. So it's a, we also, if you are you forgetting us, but we do not forget you in our entire life. So it's a big thing for us. Thank you so much, friends.